ESPN and the Professional Bowlers Association present the $140,000 Kessler Open. Now let's preview today's top five finalists, making his third appearance in the championship finals this year. 25-year-old Mike Shady will begin from the bottom rung on the stepladder. His opponent in the opening test will be 35-year-old Bill Oakes of Irving, Texas. Parker Bone III has bowled his way back to the championship round for the second time in 3 weeks, while Scott Devers of Richmond, Indiana has solidified his position on today's telecast by nailing down the runner-up position. And the top seed after 42 games here in Dublin this week, it's seven-time champion Del Ballard Jr. of Richardson, Texas. Welcome to Earl Anthony's Dublin Bowl, located in Dublin, California, for today's championship round finals of the $140,000 Kessler Open. Hi, everybody. I'm Denny Schreiner, and welcome to the house that Earl built, the great Earl Anthony's Dublin Bowl here in Dublin, California. Earl, of course, with 41 career championships and 5 seniors titles, represented himself very well here against the youngsters this week as he finished up 19th. And working with me once again in his familiar analyst role is PBA Hall of Famer Mike Durbin. Mike, let's talk about Del Ballard. He could join 3 other PBA players if he wins today with 3 titles.
Yes, Denny, he won the last tournament, the doubles tournament for the PBA, with his partner Bob Minoy. He won earlier this winter in Long Island. So if he wins, he's going to join David Ozio, Pete Weber, and John Massa as 3-time winners. So he's had right in the ring for Bowler of the Year honors. And remember, he gave one away when he threw it in the channel in Baltimore and let Pete Weber win.
Mike, in watching the championship round last night, the position game in particular, I saw all 5 players, the 5 on the telecast today, playing the lanes 5 different ways, and they were all striking. So we're going to see a variety here today.
And we're going to see a variety of styles, and I think that speaks well for the PBA lane maintenance crew. In that 5th position, we kind of have the consummate collegiate player in Mike Shady. That's how he got weaned on collegiate action. He strokes the ball, has a very solid game. His opponent kind of represents the old guard. Bill Oakes likes to throw the ball hard. He likes to play that outside angle. He likes the lanes hooking. He was weaned on kind of action bowling, pot game bowling. In the middle, we have Parker Bone, the prototype professional, a left-hander who crosses a lot of boards. Last year, he won 3 tournaments and $170,000. This year, he hasn't won. He's only won $38,000. And waiting to bowl that semifinal match, we have a left-hander in Scott Devers who goes very straight, but he always seems to sneak in a win, and he has 4 of them so far this year.
I know you and Earl had an opportunity to put together the tip for today's telecast. You threw some shots on the championship round pair, and it is hooking.
Well, all the lanes are hooking out here tonight, Denny. And even my ball was hooking, and you say it never hooks. So I don't know what Del Ballard is going to do, but he's managed to lead the tournament so far.
All right, we'll be back with the start of match number 1 momentarily. $23,000 on top this week. The championship round finals of the $140,000 Kessler Open are being brought to you by Budweiser, the king of beers. With that clean, crisp, cold taste, nothing beats a Bud. By Midas, for mufflers, brakes, and shocks. Nobody beats Midas, nobody. And by Tenactin, get the medicine that acts tough. Tough Actin, Tenactin. And the opening match will feature Mike Shady and Bill Oakes when we return to Earl Anthony's Dublin Bowl in Dublin, California.
Years, Midas has been providing quiet, installing quality products for clean, safe, and quiet driving.
Well, it's time we made some noise! Yeah! Midas announces Quiet Ryan Day. We're celebrating our anniversary with great values on quality muffler, brake, and suspension services. Guaranteed! So get to the Riot, and we'll provide the quiet. The Midas Quiet Riot. For great values, nobody beats Midas.
Nobody!
A mild case of athlete's foot is one thing. A really tough case, that's something else. The irritating itch, the painful cracking, the burning. That's when you want a medicine that acts tough. Tough-actin Tenactin. Tenactin cures even the tough cases of athlete's foot fungus. And Tenactin's clinically proven. No wonder it's the antifungal most recommended by pharmacists. So when you've got a tough case of athlete's foot, get the medicine that acts tough. Tough-actin Tenactin.
And just as he did, bowled bigger than life through most of his career, Earl Anthony, as this figure adorns both walls here at Earl Anthony's Dublin Bowl.
He does kind of represent somebody who's bigger than life, doesn't he?
Amazing. Hasn't played much at all in the last year or two. Came out and was eighth for a while yesterday morning. Ended up 19th battling the youngsters.
The flat bellies, huh?
Yeah, here's one right here, too, Mike Shady. Third telecast of the year. Comes out, opens up with a slicing strike on the championship round pair. Lanes 33 and 34.
33, the hooking lane of the two lanes. And it looks like Mike is trying to be aggressive from the get-go.
Pulled beautifully last night down the stretch in order to qualify in the number five position. Bill Oakes out of the state of Texas. Hard and straight, right?
You know, he's averaged on two ESPN telecasts a miserable 160. He says his goal is simply to bowl 200 today. And we were talking earlier about how he seems so uptight. If he could manage to get a win and relax a little bit on television, they're hooking a lot from the outside. He's using that polyester ball, a plastic ball. And he could be a force if he could just relax and make the shots that he's capable of.
And if there were a condition that would suit his game to a T, this would be it.
This seems to be it.
Waves it to come back and ends up with a disaster in the second.
And just what he didn't want to happen. You know, you want to get out with that quick double and get ahead. Instead, you're staring at an open. He's going to throw hard and straight at this 4-7, and believe me, he'll throw it up around 25, 26 miles an hour and hope something bounces out of there.
Tough break for Oakes early on, who opened with a strike. There's the fastball. Nothing doing. Nine out in the second for Bill Oakes. And Shady will step up now and lead by 12 and perhaps even 22 if he strikes.
He can really put the pressure on Mr. Oakes right away with a couple of strikes here. Get himself out quickly.
A product of the University of Nebraska's bowling program. Of course, the first year he bowled in the collegiate ranks, it was the University of Wisconsin La Crosse, where they won the national championship, three-time All-American. He comes out and tries to apply the pressure, and a bad break. Looked like the five pin went left of the seven.
Everything was around that seven, but nothing hit it. I'll tell you, that really was a bad break, because that's on a hooking condition like this one is here at Earl Anthony's Dublin Bowl. That light hit is such a high percentage hit. You're going to carry probably 85 to 90% of those hits, and he lost that one.
Has a four-year business degree and still might end up going back for a master's, trying to figure out what to do with all the money you win out here, right? Spare up for Shady in the second.
Classic starting position. Five-step approach, pushes it on the second step. Ball comes down. The peak of the backswing a little early, but he catches up with the step. The high backswing, the nice long slide. What we can't see from here as we see his finish position and the hand open up is that ball has a tendency to go quite a ways behind his back in the backswing. If there's only a slight flaw in his game, I would say that. It's hard to do that the same way every time.
Especially under pressure. A little rollout shot. This time the half 10 stands on lane 33. Let's talk about that rollout shot, Mike. It seems as if everybody's using it this week.
Well, I don't think it's that they're using it intentionally. It's the lane is dictating to it. I mean, the ball is just, it skids a certain distance, it turns on its axis, and then goes into a roll, and when it finishes that roll, if there's not enough oil on the lanes, it actually begins to go back the other way at a certain point on the lane, and that's what's happening here. The ball actually straightens out or quits at the pocket.
Couple of spares for Shady in this last effort. Oakes down by 11, but could
change that scenario if he could throw a double here in the third and the fourth.
Just needs to relax and make a couple of good shots and get a couple of good breaks here, and he can get himself right back in this match.
Billy averaged better than 243 on this particular pair of lanes throughout the tournament, so he's got a good feel for this pair of lanes as he whacks them on lane 34.
See, the mental battle that a bowler goes through all the time, then you throw that first strike, and it's just easy sometimes. But when the double is up there, as we see the style of Bill Oakes, holds that ball down, again, another five-step player, you can see the intensity as the shoulders hunch forward, a little higher than shoulder backswing. Kind of bends over as he lets it go, and again, it's not what we would teach, but he's done it so long, he makes it work for himself.
It's amazing. Watch this. There's no push away at all. The ball goes right into the swing.
Right.
More speed, and he makes the adjustment, goes light on the left-hand lane, leaves the two pin.
And now, in your mind, you know, you're a little left and you're high, a little right, and it doesn't make it back. And what happens is the ball just doesn't come off your hand quite the way you want it to. When you throw it a little wide like that, if you catch it with the fingers heavier, it makes it back. But he's just not quite throwing the shot that he wants to when he has the strike up.
And now a major league mistake for Bill Oakes, who flags the two-pin. And there you see the eyes roll up and look to the heavens. And you can't make mistakes like that in the championship round or in any match, for that matter, on the PBA Tour.
Not against this kind of competition.
Oh, boy.
And invariably, the unwritten rule that always seems to happen in the PBA Tour is when you open like that, your opponent doubles.
Trying to shake it off. Meanwhile, Shady's trying to open things up a little bit. Perfect shot, 10-10 the last to lead, but a strike for Shady on lane 34.
And it's interesting, Billy is 35 and a lot of experience and been around a long time. Mike is 25, but the poise between the two seems to be with the younger man right now. The confidence seems to be with the younger player. The mental battle is being won by the 25-year-old.
It's amazing what happens when we get to the championship round.
I used to be under that kind of pressure under
sure.
One strike.
You have to fight through it.
Here it comes. Gets the light hit this time.
Down by 33 now after Shady doubled in the fourth and the fifth. Nothing like digging the hole yourself.
Well, yeah, like you say, he's done it to himself then. But his opponent came out with four or five in a row.
Mm-hmm. Turned it early. Major league break, though, with the strike on the right-hand lane. And if he could muster the courage to throw the shot that he wants on 33 and get a double, it might loosen up his arm swing considerably.
Well, you know, he doesn't have a loose swing to begin with.
No.
I mean, it's a muscle game all the way through. He kind of forces the swing to match the steps. And it's the type of game that you come out, and if you bowl for a while, you know, you get into a nice feel. But to come out and have to perform instantly in one game, it's hard to do.
Plenty of room. Does he get the break? Here it is at the last moment. That'll loosen up Bill Oakes as he cuts into that lead. And, of course, tomorrow is Father's Day. All five of our finalists will be traveling, and they want to wish the best to their fathers throughout the country.
Happy Father's Day, Dad, and have a wonderful day tomorrow. In addition to that, I want to wish my sister a happy graduation and good luck in the future.
Feeling lost when it comes to finding quality automotive service? Lebzelders in Elizabethtown would like to help you find the way. Their trained technicians get the job done right, from total vehicle alignment, lube and oil change, to wheel balance, rotation, and more. From downtown Elizabethtown, take Route 230 to Cloverleaf Road, left on Mertz Drive. Off Route 283, Reams exit to Mertz Drive. Follow Mertz Drive past Messick Farm Equipment. You found the way to quality automotive service at Lebzelders Field and Fleet Center in Elizabethtown.
Hi, I'm Greg LeMond, honorary chairperson for the National Multiple Sclerosis MS-150 Bike Tour. From April through November, thousands of Americans will join in one of the nation's fastest-growing cycling events. Whether you ride an MS-150 for the challenge, for fun, or to help fight the effects of MS, be a winner and ride. For information on how you can join the MS-150, call your local MS Society chapter and start cycling.
You're so proud. Think you would be beautiful. Do it for yourself with Minwax and Wood.
Get beautiful color with Minwax Wood Finish and lasting protection with Minwax Polyurethane.
So do yourself proud with Minwax and Wood.
While we were gone, a strike in the sixth for Shady, and then a solid 10-pin in the seventh, so Oaks on a double, trailing by 32.
And if he's ever going to do anything, now's the time to do it.
Maybe the best shot of the week for Bill Oaks.
Important shot coming up, though. Right now, he can cut into that 22-pin lead and cut it down to 12, put four in a row together. And his goal going in was to bowl over 200. If he gets one more, he's going over a 200 pace. So he knows that.
Left-hand lane has been the troublesome lane.
And it's interesting, you know, between our five finalists, they threw during the week probably 35 gunner balls. And so we may see one on the air tonight.
Oh, you had to bring it up. Whisper when Del Ballard's on the approach, all right? Good speed. He needs a break, and he gets another one, Mike Durbin. Out of the blue, the 8-pin drops.
And he really hasn't found lane 33 at all. You know, the 1-pin has to hit the 2 in order to get a strike. See, let's watch this and see if the 1 hits the 2. It clips it. See, and it falls backward. A couple of pins, 5 and the 2 there, and it was the 5 that actually got that 8 on.
Body English, there you see the thrust of the arm into the air, a four-bagger, and it's a 12-pin match. Pressure back to Mike Shady, who responds with a beautiful strike on 34.
Really is a poised young man, isn't he? I like his demeanor. I like his body English. He just is communicating to me, at least, that he's very confident inside. There we see that at 15 feet, the ball is going almost 20 miles per hour at the 8. About the 8th board, and it slowed down about 4 miles per hour by the time it got to 55 feet. We're measuring at, but it went from the 11th board to the 17th board in the last 5 feet.
Plenty of hook. This one got to about the 16 board as he leaves the 2-pin. Of course, we want to thank the good folks at Brunswick for supplying us with bowler track once again here on the PBA Summer Tour, an opportunity to chart where the pros are playing the lanes and the speeds that they're utilizing.
Well, we've seen 1 2-pin or missed already today. I'm sure Mr. Shady, though, is going to hit this right square in the face.
This could be a interesting finish here to start match number one, because Oaks has a possible 236.
And the best that Shady can get is 228, so Mr. Oaks' fate is in his own hands, and I'm sure that heart is beating right now. He's still trailing by 12 pins, can cut it to 2 on a lane that he has struck on every time. Gave it room. Here it comes. Oh, that was his best shot, Dennis.
A truck on lane 34, and Oaks now in a position to put Shady away.
And we see how fast he started. 15 feet, 21.2. At 55 feet, that ball went 5.5 boards left at 55 feet. He slowed down almost 3 miles per hour, but still very, very quick. Be interesting to see if this one goes even harder, Dennis, because this lane hooks more.
Shady just hoping for an opportunity to step up in the 10th and win his first match, but it's all up to Bill Oaks now. Head down.
Ooh.
And probably the best shot that he's thrown in the left-hand lane, he ends up leaving the 4-pin.
He was left with it right from the get-go, but the ball did hold pocket with that good speed. Makes this and picks it up, and he's already, in fact, he hasn't had a spare in this game, Dan. He's got 7 strikes and no spares. 4-pin, he should be able to convert, though.
I was going to wait a moment, and so does Billy, because he missed the 2-pin earlier on. That's going to come back and haunt him, perhaps.
Strike finishes with 215, would force Mr. Shady to count 18 in that 10th frame to win the match.
So a mark of some sort and some count.
Well, at least he achieved his goal of shooting over 200, but I'm sure he's up that goal to winning the game right now. Count's important, though.
Boy, a looser swing there and a beautiful strike for Oakes, who walks back and can only think about the couple of shots that he threw that he would love to have back.
Well, the two pin that he missed cost him 11 pins. He would have had 226 if he'd have made that.
Which would have forced Shady to double and then some in the 10th to win.
Right. Mike, who's been very solid on this right-hand lane, has not missed the pocket on this lane yet. A little loft. Not his best shot. He kind of hung in that thumb and left the four pin. Saw that follow through go shooting to the right real quick, which indicates usually that the ball is going a little left.
Told me that if you set it short at all, it was left immediately. His thought most of the week here at Earl Anthony's Dublin Bowl was to project the ball a little bit to the right to make sure he gave it plenty of room.
Yeah, plus he moved his target further down the lane to help him accomplish that task.
If you do that, it just kind of naturally allows you to get the ball further down the lane before it hooks.
Right. Well, a tie is eminently possible. Nine or a strike, and he wins. Eight, we're going to have a two-frame roll-off. Less than eight, Mr. Oakes goes on.
Had a feeling this one might come down to the final shot. Parker Bone III warming up. He is the next opponent. Scott Devers is qualified number two, and Del Ballard Jr., former ABC Masters champion and Firestone Tournament of Champions champ, is our top seed. A little smoother release.
Just enough. Back-to-back shots. Four-pin, and he gets a win at 216 to 215.
Billy Oakes applauds him and says, job well done in the 10th. I had my opportunity, but I'll have to take the check for $5,000 and head to the Great Northwest, which is where the touring pros go next week. Of course, coming up when we return, Mike Durbin's Average Builder.
Red Devil enamel. You can always count on its durable finish. Harder than ordinary paints, its beauty lasts and lasts. Red Devil enamel, for the finish of a lifetime.
Which clamp is faster?
An old-fashioned screw-type clamp.
Or the revolutionary Quick Grip bar clamp.
Let's watch closely.
Here they go.
The instant replay.
And look at that. One finger on the quick release trigger and the bar slides right into position.
And he's tightening the clamp by merely squeezing the quick grip handle. And it's done. You know, unlocking the clamp again was a very nice touch.
The quick grip bar clamp, available wherever quality tools are sold.
Tomorrow morning, experience a new high. Introducing Mountain Fresh Dial, with a scent so big, so bold, so bracing, it's right up there with your peak experiences. New Mountain Fresh Dial.
Average Builders is brought to you by Pizza Hut, home of the incredible picnic pairs deal. Pizza Hut, making it great.
For this afternoon's Average Builder, I'd like to talk about tempo. And first, I'd like to define it as simply the rhythm that we have as we go to the foul line. And let me say that everybody's tempo is different. Some people like to play a song in their head all the way through their evening of bowling. Other people take a more mechanical approach. For myself, I kind of fall into that latter category. I kind of like an army cadence. And the keys for me is, as I'm standing and ready to get ready to throw the ball, is I like to try and relax every muscle in my body. As I put my hand in the ball, I relax my hand and my shoulders and even my jaw. And then as I start, I like to try and make it smooth with the hand and the foot going right together at the same time. And my last key is I hit the next to last step where the backswing is ready to become the downswing. I try and relax the shoulder and let the weight of the ball bring that ball into the downswing. Those are my keys. For another viewpoint, let's ask our host this week, Mr. Earl Anthony, a bowler that many consider the greatest of all time. Earl, what are the keys for you for your tempo?
Mine's a little different than yours, Mike. I try to control the ball completely through the arm swing. I'm not nearly as relaxed as you are, and I try to time my feet to the ball, so I'm always in control. The strengths in my game have always been accuracy and speed control, and the only way I feel I can be consistent with my feed control is to know where the ball is in relation to my feet at all times throughout the swing. What do you say we show them how to do it?
Okay, Earl. There you have it. Two different styles from two different senior bowlers. You be sure and join us next Thursday night from Flint, Michigan, 7:30 Eastern Time for another Average Builder. And if you have trouble in the meantime, see your local PBA pro.
Senior bowlers. No way. The juniors are up next, though. Shady and Parker Bone III in what should be an excellent match here from Earl Anthony's Dublin Bowl. Get out the hair coloring, right, Michael?
You call Pizza Hut?
Yep.
Good thing they deliver.
Yep.
Though, if Pizza Hut didn't deliver, I guess we could call another place.
What other place?
Call Pizza Hut Delivery for the new Italian Classic Combo Pizza, packed with Italian sausage and pepperoni. One medium's $8.99, a second's just $4 more.
Time for game? No thanks. I guess people just don't like Domino's anymore.
Guess not. Pizza Hut Delivery, making it
great. You don't have to worry when rain keeps pouring down. Cause your home can take it, whatever comes around.
Olympic Oil Stain has pure linseed oil. Since oil and water don't mix, it helps stop water damage.
It's no wonder we'll stop the rain.
Olympic stops the rain. All Olympic products are on sale now for a limited time at Sears.
Oh, say, can you see the great sports in July on ESPN? You'll see America's favorite pastime 4 nights a week. Booming drives bursting in air at the British Open, U.S. Women's Open, and the U.S. Senior Open. American Olympic hopefuls taking their first steps toward Olympic glory at the U.S. Olympic Festival. Plus, down-home NASCAR racing excitement in the land of the free and the home of great sports in July on ESPN.
Two of the talented young Lions on the PBA Tour, Parker Bone III and Mike Shady, will clash here in game number two, and Parker Bone will open up on the left-hand lane after a re-rack.
Unusual to re-rack the very first frame. Parker's told me that he's using a very hard ball right now, and one that doesn't hook, and he's breaking his wrist back as far as he can trying to make the ball go straighter, something that he normally doesn't do on his first ball. And we have a balk right there.
Did the runners advance on that kind of a...
right.
Holy cow, Parker hung on to that one, backs up, uses the towel, and apparently he heard something, was disturbed right in the middle of his approach.
What he said was the pinball game didn't go right. He heard the pinball game going... That, you talk about rabbit ears.
Talk about concentration, though. He was able to pull it back. Let's see what kind of a shot he throws to open things up. Well... That's what a true professional will do. Shook up, comes back, throws the strike, and says, throw another quarter in the pinball machine.
Now, it's amazing to me. These two young men really are exhibiting just so much poise. I kind of marvel that they're able to do that young in their career. I'm 50 and still haven't learned then, so.
Something tells me that in the old days, Coach Durbin would have turned around and glared, perhaps, at the pinball machines.
Never.
A strike for Shady, who comes out quickly as well.
Well, you know, I'm learning later in life that perception is everything. And Parker's perception on that was that he wasn't going to let that thing disturb him. He took a humorous approach to it and was able to overcome it.
Shady with a 216-215 victory over Billy Oaks to start the championship round has his hands full here in game two.
But he's proving that he's a handful, too. You know, it could be the other way around, that Parker Bone has his hands full with Mike Shady.
Earlier this spring, Shady bowled in the title match against John Mazza, lost in Fresno, but he has been knocking on the door as of late. He'd love to win his first championship.
Well, in that match, he was ahead in that match, and John Mazza happened to get a couple of Brooklyn strikes, and Shady got a couple of opens and turned it around.
Parker to the one board and back, and has left an assortment on lane 34.
The 3 and the 9, Parker, in fact, for both of the right-handers and left-handers, the left lane 33 hooks both more for both lefties and righties. So the 34 a little tighter, he didn't quite make it up. Got the spare. Parker with just a classic game, ball held waist high, pushes and steps at the same time. backswing very high. Look at the power step and the nice long slide. Watch the follow through right up by the ear. Love it to watch his game.
And don't forget the Pirates take the best record in baseball and, of course, the best road record in baseball, the Candlestick Park, as they'll do battle with the San Francisco Giants. Sunday Night Baseball on ESPN, and not a good pitch that time for Parker.
Interesting that he has a purple ball on the rack that hooks slightly more, and I watched him in practice, and I thought the purple ball reacted better than this red one, but he's gone with the one that goes straighter. That one on the left right there, the purple one there.
That magenta?
Ooh, as the three goes right around the seven. What a tough break. It's a bad break to leave that split and then to cover it perfect and not make it.
Parker now trailing by 23, and you can't throw it much better than that, but you do need a little bit of luck on those split conversions.
Yeah.
Shady has opened with a double, and he'll try and extend that string. Ooh, got out of that one and got a major break there as he tripped out the four and the ten.
What did you see? You talk about the rollout shot, Dan. That one rolled out major league right at the pocket. It was headed for the nose and just quit and almost went right. Pins ahead, we see, as we get a look at that last shot. Now watch the ball's going left, left, left. Now it goes almost straight at the end and trips out that 4-7-10.
Could have been disaster. Ends up in a strike. And this time through the nose again, but doesn't get the break and leaves the three in the six.
Just seemed like that shot was softer from the get-go. Just not the enthusiasm, the adrenaline in that shot. Parker trying to get that ball to feel right. Come up light twice in a row in both the second and third frame. Could be that he told me that because of this hand release, his thumb is kind of flying out quicker and he has to make the thumb hold tighter.
Better, though, to get that thumb out quick.
Well, yeah, but when you get it out quick, if you don't catch it with the fingers, too, then it doesn't make it back.
Right.
You kind of lose the ball off your hand. The trouble is that when you make that thumb hold tighter, that plays tricks on your mind. Am I going to get out of it or am I not?
And especially if you have a tendency to squeeze it a little bit late in the match. That one came whistling off. Nice shot, nice reaction. Parker bounces back with a strike in the fourth.
No quit in Parker Bone. Seems to have the same demeanor no matter what's happening. 170,000 last year, as we see this shot. Hardly slowed down at all. 0.6 mile. At the bottom, that's at 15 feet. And, of course, at the top of the screen, it's at 55 feet. And it's going from the ninth board to the 17th board in the last 5 feet.
The harder surface balls would slow down less, right, because less friction?
That's correct.
Glares at the 7th pin. Wanted that one very badly. Could have closed the gap to 21 with a strike there.
Also tells me that it appears to be that the lane is slightly tighter on the left side of the lane, I would think, than on the right.
It was tough to win matches this week. Scott Devers was chatting with us just prior to the telecast. He went 11-13 and ended up second. Amazing. Del Ballard won 3 matches yesterday morning with 180 or less.
And he shot under for the block and won 6 matches. Parker's chance to put some pressure on Mr. Shady and get him to squeeze that ball a little bit. Foiled by that 7th pin. Oh, the old solid 8 pops up all the time. Leaving those for a lot of years. Shady, I'm sure, will leave a lot more.
No defense.
No, you just got to pick up the spare and throw it right back in the same place again.
Somewhere down the line, though, you throw an errant shot and you end up with a strike.
That's what they say.
you probably have a loose leaf notebook somewhere with all the 8 pins that you ever left in your entire career.
No.
With a vengeance.
I put them out of my mind now.
30 pins separating Parker Bone and Mike Shady. Shady has been a pretty steady customer thus far. He got ahead of Billy Oaks by hitting the pocket and had to hang on to win, but that's the same scenario here in game number 2.
That's the way you want to do it in match play competition. So many times you get out ahead, put that pressure on the other guy. It's tough to catch up.
in a one-game match. You're not kidding. Plenty of fingers and a beautiful strike for Mike Shady, who leads by 30. And even though Billy Oaks left a little early and finished fifth, he had this to say to his dad for Father's Day.
Dad, I'd just like to wish you a happy Father's Day, and you're a special person to me. I wish I was there with you. Have a good day tomorrow, and I'd like to say hi to my daughter, Lauren, and my son, Nicholas.
Beware of HBO's all-new episodes of Tales from the Crypt. You won't believe your eyes. You may lose your grip. Or kiss a little jumping. That's how it ghouls with our terrific tales of murder, madness, and mayhem. And that's just the fun part. Tune in and you just might be another satisfied customer. Tales from the Crypt. It's only on HBO.
I like what shampoo and conditioner do for my hair, but I love what Pert Plus does for me. Pert Plus is a unique shampoo and conditioner in one, so my hair turns out just the way I like it. Clean, conditioned, looking great, but without the bother of two bottles. Imagine, hair I like without the fuss. That's what Pert Plus does for me. If only everything in my life was so simple.
Wash and go with Pert Plus. Also in dandruff control.
While we were away, a real mess for Parker Bone in the sixth when he left 2-4-6-7-10 and could not convert. Came back, though, with a strike in the seventh.
But he's going at a 169 pace, Dennis, and 48 pins behind Mr. Shady, cruising along, throwing most balls in the pocket. Throws that one in the pocket, increases it to 58. In fact, if I multiply it out right now, the best Parker can get if he strikes out is 209, and that would mean that Mike Shady would have to open twice for Parker to have a chance. So doesn't look hopeful for Parker Bowen at this point.
Well, in nearly two games, Shady has missed the pocket with only one shot. So he appears to be pretty well lined up. Meanwhile, Parker has thrown some strikes, but he hasn't been able to put much together. Messenger doesn't quite get the job done on the 10-pin. Shady cruising along here. Scott Devers will be next in line should Shady advance in game number two. Of course, next week you and I will be in Flint. First time that the PBA Tour, the seniors have been up in that direction. And I know you're excited about that one, the Flint PBA Senior Open. And it'll be shown live on ESPN next Thursday night beginning at 7:30.
At Richfield Bowl was just up there yesterday, and the people are looking forward to having all the seniors there and going to have a great tournament for their first-time event.
57-pin lead. When you've got the Heinz ketchup lead, you know, you're in pretty good shape.
And Parker just cannot miss now. And he gets another open, or staring at another open, and he's going to be shooting in the 150s.
Leaves the 367. Interesting observation on your part during the last commercial. You felt that perhaps the choice of equipment for Parker might have been the other ball because he just doesn't have any room for error with this one.
Now, he's got to be perfect to throw the ball into the 1-2. He just can't make any kind of mistake at all. That plays havoc with your mind and with your swing and... this time with your score.
He'll shake it off. One of the bright young stars. Won three times last year and earned better than $170,000. His third championship round appearance of this season. He's made all three championship rounds on ESPN this summer. He's just got to figure out how to win a few.
Well, he got to pull more than 150 to win games out here.
Yeah,
unfortunately, that doesn't get it done.
No.
I know my last game on TV ever was 150, so didn't win me anything. There's the other ball.
So for Parker, a day that he'd like to forget. An excellent week, though. A solid week. Meanwhile, Mike Shady just continues to climb the ladder. Doesn't say a whole lot. Doesn't react very much. Pretty much all business.
Well, he's very professional about how he approaches the game. Decided earlier this year that he'd become burnt out on the sport, went to a sports psychologist, revamped his mental game as he throws another ball in the 1-3 pocket in the ninth frame, and has come out with a renewed vigor.
Possible 246 for the youngster from Ripon, Wisconsin. Maybe put together a three-year program out here. He would come out, bowl full-time for 3 years, and assess his growth, the money potential, his game, competition. And
very mature way to approach it, I would say.
And then decide whether or not he's going to go on with it. Well, I'm here to tell you, if he's looking for a sponsor, between you and I, we should put something together.
One good thing about this, in this game, he wins it by 50 pins or more. He's up by almost 70, and he's left two solid eights to win a game that easy, and those solid eights are not a factor. Sometimes bodes well down the line.
If you're Scott Devers and you're watching Shady just do nothing but hit the pocket, what's going through your mind?
What's going through my mind, if I'm Scott Devers over there, is that my game plan is I better bowl 220 or better to beat this young man. That he's going to keep throwing him in the pocket. The lane should do nothing but get it better for him.
Possible 226 for Mike Shady. And a second consecutive win. He's already defeated Billy Oaks, 216 to 215. He'll set his sights on Scott Devers coming up next. Top seed, Del Ballard Jr. Solid game for a steady player, Mike Shady. 226 says he's a winner, and Parker Bone also wanted to wish his dad a happy Father's Day.
To my father and my mother, happy Father's Day. To my dad tomorrow, wish you all the best. My mom, happy birthday. Her birthday's this week. I'd like to say hello to my wife, Mary, and my son, Parker.
Providing professional and trusted service to Lancaster County homes and businesses for over 30 years, we are the Rohrer Company. Whether commercial or residential, the Rohrer Company is committed to providing excellent service, professional workmanship, and quality products. We take immense pride in the detail and quality of our work, the way you expect it to be. The Rohrer Company.
Do you have cable?
No.
Other show. Gerbil. And the umbrella. Guess you had to be there. Do you have cable? Wrong floor.
A look at the rest of the top 24. Walter Ray made a great run last night, coming up just 11 pins short.
Robert Lawrence been steady last year and this year.
Pete McCormick, Mr. 300, and Wayne Webb with a solid week.
And he was leader earlier in the week. John Force throws that big hook in. The red-hot left-hander John Mazza had a chance.
A tie there for 10th. Tom Kreitz with a solid finish. Joe Salvemini back in the finals.
David Arnold and Eric Forkel, another nice solid left-handed bowler.
Lots of ties this week. The defending champ, Butch Soper, at 16th. Mike Edwards, number 17.
And Don Cinello, and of course our host here, the great Earl Anthony.
David D'Entremont in the 20 position. Chris Warren bouncing back. He finished 21st.
Oh, the past president, Ernie Schlegel and Jim Tilton from down in Southern California.
And 24th, Joe Merrill. And that's a look at the top 24 for this year's $140,000 Kessler Open. Shady is 2 for 2. Next man in his sights, Scott Devers. We'll be back with a semifinal match from Earl Anthony's Dublin Bowl in Dublin, California, right after these messages.
You know, people say to me, Sonny, you're rich, handsome, and talented, and I say, oh, contraire, I'm not rich. That's why I got the new coupon book available from any choice hotel like Econolodge, Roadway, and Friendship. It could save you over $1,000 at places like Pizza Hut, Alamo Rent-A-Car, and Theme Park. Call now.
Because they've got yours, babe.
Call 1-800-4-CHOICE to reserve your room and free coupon book. Supplies are limited.
What's your way?
The Whopper from Burger King. Plain broiled, never fried. Made just the way you want it.
Have it your way. What's your way?
For a taste that's all your own.
Have it any way you want it. Take it off or put it on it.
The Whopper from Burger King. Fixed fresh, served hot.
What's your way?
Your way right away.
Don't
Tevo clear polyurethane. You can always count on its durable finish. Harder than ordinary clear finishes, its beauty lasts and lasts. Red Devil clear polyurethane for the finish of a lifetime.
Competitors know that it takes power to score. Power in your approach. Power in your equipment. Witness the devastating result of premium urethane charged with a secret additive and explosive high-energy impact for better corner carry. Even arc, more hook, the perfectly matched two-piece ball, the U2 from Columbia 300.
A beautiful baseball reporter met a pitcher who started to court her. She was pleased with his pitch till he started to twitch from an itch in his athletic supporter.
Croix kills chuck itch fungus.
A wonderful trophy and $23,000 in first place prize money up for grabs in the Kessler Open. Scott Devers and Mike Shady will go at it here in the semifinal. Shady averaging 222 as seven strikes on the right-hand lane.
So we got three bachelors left going for this title.
Right.
Just thought I'd throw that in there.
It's a difference if you're... Did you bowl as a bachelor, Mike, on the PBA tour? You were already married.
I was already married.
That would have to be quite a bit different. Got to be more pressure if you're married and have a family, right?
I would think so.
Sure.
Solid 10 for Shady, the first time he didn't get out of the gate real quick, although in the first match he went strike, spare, spare, so.
I'm impressed with the way that he has operated here on the championship round there.
Not a lot of flair, but it's certainly been effective. Just throwing ball after ball after ball in the pocket, kind of like a football team with a ground attack, you know, just keep gaining yards.
Yep, 3 yards and a cloud of dust. Now let's see if Scott Devers can derail Mike Shady here in the semifinal. Devers, a very deceptive player. Does nothing but hit the pocket. Head pin bounces around, 7-pin stands.
You know, he made the championship round format at the Firestone Tournament of Champions earlier this year. They have a press breakfast the morning of the telecast, and they asked him about his style. And even he admitted that he hadn't realized what his style looked like until he saw it, and he realized how ugly it was. That were his words, not our words.
Do whatever you want, but the last foot of that swing, everything is lined up, and he is a repeater. He has spent some time working with Team USA head coach Fred Borden over the past couple of years.
And I remember a comment by Tommy Hudson years ago that out here they don't pay for looks, they pay for results, you know. So
yes. How many strikes are you throwing and what's the average? Yeah. And can you execute when the heat is really turned up?
And Scott Devers has proved in the past that he can do that.
Well, he already has four titles to his credit. Shady looking for his first professional victory. A whack on the left-hand lane for Scott Devers, who fitted that ball nicely on lane 33.
And he's picked the hooking lane to finish on. Everybody else had picked the tighter lane, so.
Ooh, flirting with the one board. Roll-out shot, and he carries the four-pin.
He's got that shot down pat on that right lane.
And a couple of former NFL stars, Michael Carter and also Marv Hubbard, on hand here today. Michael Carter is a former Green Bay Packer and also a San Diego Charger, and he is the president of the newly formed Northern California chapter of the NFL Players Association. And Marv Hubbard had an interesting observation. You know, bowling's a lot like football because you knock things down all the time. I like that mentality, don't you?
Yeah, right. What do you knock people down?
Oh, boy. Big people. And speaking of knocking things down, there goes the 8-pin as a sigh of relief comes from Shady, who says, what do I have to do to get strikes on this championship round pin?
Boy, that 8-pin was slow.
Thank you.
And the seventh in again. Interesting, we've been talking about Father's Day and these bowlers have all been commenting that what their fathers mean to them, wishing happy Father's Day. And a couple of PBA champions that have recently become fathers on the PBA Tour are Guppy Troop and Brian Voss. So we have to wish happy Father's Day to them tomorrow.
Now the burning question for me is, does Guppy name his child Minnow?
Oh.
Guppy, if you're out there listening, please, please be careful.
And Scott with a four-step delivery, kind of figure eights that shot. Wrist broken at the back, straight through, good loft at the finish, and we see it from behind. Now watch this, Dennis. He pushes and steps, swing goes out. At this point, it doesn't look like he can get lined up, but it comes right back here. Look at how straight it goes through there at the point of release. That's the key. From the top of that swing down, it's just like anybody else's.
Well, one of the great figure eight arm swings of all time, Billy Wailu.
Right.
Hey, as long as you drop it back in the slot.
It just is, when you're doing all that, it's easier for something to go wrong, is the theory. In practice, Scott's very consistent.
Well, as Coach Borden so often explains, you try and get that arm swing into a 4-inch professional groove. 4 inches is about all you want to play with, and obviously Scott is outside of that. Six pin covered in the fourth.
And Mr. Shady stepping up with a chance to add to that 11-pin lead and put it up to 21. Taking a little extra time here.
A little more speed. Uh-oh, that one hooked early. Right now, it's Mike Shady's day, though. Every time he's thrown an errant shot, he's gotten away with it.
Well, that one was by far the most errant shot that he's thrown this afternoon. I guess if you're going to make a mistake, make it big enough to get it over on the crossover side. Leaves the six pin. Could have struck. Keeps Mr. Devers in the game, though.
Well, that was on a double. That was an unusual shot for Mike Shady. It's been nothing but consistent on the championship round pair here today. No problem with the six pin. And he continues to lead. And don't forget, tomorrow on ESPN, from the International Tennis Hall of Fame in Newport, Rhode Island, it's 1991 Davis Cup tennis action, the United States versus Spain. I had a chance to watch John McEnroe win yesterday, and he was pleased about that.
I'm sure he was. Mm-hmm.
From the cockpit here at Earl Anthony's Dublin Bowl. Let's see, do we get the opportunity to land? Yes, we do. Circling in for the final. Director Kent Samuel cuts to another. No, he didn't. Interesting. We went with a wide angle shot that time.
Well, that is the viewpoint that we have, and Mr. Shady keeps throwing him in the pocket, except for one little mistake there in the fourth frame, but he got away with it.
So contrary to popular belief, you and I actually do have some idea of what's going on out there.
Contrary to popular belief, yes.
Devers trying to make something happen. Oh, he liked it, and at the last moment, the nine pin fell. Or make that the 8-pin, I should say. The lefty is going to leave the 6-8.
Right? All right, you keep thinking like a right-hander over there.
I got to get myself turned around.
And Scott, who's thrown all five shots into the 1-2 pocket, has only one strike to show for that. That's only 20%. It's not too good.
Doggone 6-pin is still wiggling. Trying to fine-tune the adjustments on the championship round pair and come up with a double. Close match, though. He's down by only 11.
Sometimes when it goes like that, then once the strikes do start coming, you get four or five in a row. So we'll see if Scott can do something here the latter half of this game.
Well, Devers is the type of player, too, Mike, that's not going to play himself out of a match.
Very seldom. You know. The only way is if the other bowler bowls him out of the match by stringing strikes.
Ah, there goes the seven pin. So Devers comes back with a strike, and he finally remembers a man that was very near and dear to his heart, his father, on Father's Day.
Yes, if I should win today, I would like to dedicate this tournament to my father. He died while bowling league about several years ago.
Hey, buddy, want to make $1 million the easy way? You could step into the ring. You could dabble in junk bonds.
Or you could play the HBO TV Guide Quest for the Best Game. Play daily in TV Guide and nightly on HBO. So hold on to that game card for your daily chance to win over 8,000 cash prizes. Play the HBO TV Guide Quest for the Best Game and make your first million the easy way.
You're not just looking at a beer. Far more. The ultimate refinement of the brewmeist is art. The finest grains. The choicest hop.
Coors Light, the official beer of the 90s, is the fastest growing premium light beer in America. It keeps growing and growing and growing.
Back to Earl Anthony's Dublin Bowl in the sixth. Shady left the four pin, picked it up, and he leads, as you can see, by 11. Much better speed on that shot and a good reaction.
You know, what's scary to me, Dennis, is I add the ages of these two guys together, and they're barely older than I am. So,
so what's the point that you're trying to make?
I don't know.
The players are getting younger or that you're getting older?
I think both.
Bowler track from 17.7 down to 16.7.
All hooking seven boards in the last 5 feet. And Scott going for more speed on this lane after almost leaving the 6-8 the time before, leaves what Parker Bowen left a couple of times on lane 34, the 3-7.
Appeared to hang up on that shot, as the Brunswick Bowler track shows us that it started at 18.9 and finished at 18.6.
Yeah, hardly slowed down at all. The ball just kind of skidded down the lane and never really got into a good roll.
Needs to convert this.
And does perfectly. I was going to say that he was very accurate and makes a lot of splits. That keeps him within 11 pins and keeps him having a chance in this match. Stroke this one much better. If you're going to make it, this is the perfect way. He knows what it means to him.
Right on the numbers. Needs a strike here in the eighth.
Oh, a solid eight pin. He just cannot get any kind of break.
We've seen some interesting taps thus far and some very tough ones. Shady's left a couple of solid eights, and that came at a very inopportune time.
And you would think that Scott throwing a straighter shot, that solid eight would not be a leave that he would leave very often, especially in this kind of a situation. 12 pins the difference. Shady, who's been struggling a little bit on lane 34 the last couple of times, left a six pin on a crossover and a four pin on a ball that was high all the way. Now it's an opportunity on this lane to really put the heat on Scott.
Scott's optimum score would be 217.
Even more room. That's it. He just needs to get that ball right on that lane 34 with good speed, and it winds up in the 1-3.
Clutch double in the eighth for Shady.
Still not finished yet, though. I mean, even if he strikes here, Scott Deaver still has a chance. If he could strike out, he would make Mr. Shady mark.
249, a possibility for Mike Shady. Who, other than a couple of shots in nearly three games, has been letter perfect as far as hitting the pocket. Stepped up and raised up on that shot and left the baby split.
Just was anxious, wanted to get that strike up on the board, and just forgot about what he was doing. Needs to make this to maintain a 20-pin lead.
When you haven't shot at something like the baby split, Mike, in three games, is that going through your mind?
Oh, yeah. He's thinking, well, do I play it off my strike angle or do I move left and throw it straight? Hopefully, you know, he practiced it in the practice round and knows approximately where to stand and throw. Looks like he's moving left and going to throw straight.
Those are the kind of key shots that you have to make in order to win a title.
That's exactly right, Dennis. In a key situation like that in the ninth frame.
Just a wonderful conversion there, the baby split.
and he threw it hard and straight, and this is the textbook way to make that split.
Devers trying to keep his hopes alive, needs a break and doesn't get it. Gambled that time and went high.
Just forced it on that lane. The time before, you know, he was light. What's going through his mind is that I don't have any room here. I've got to be perfect, and he didn't make a quality shot. Now he has the 2-7, the same thing for a left-hander.
Of course, we talked about Parker Bone maybe using a different surface ball, but if he did, maybe it hooked way too much. That's why the players are using the harder surface bowling balls, because if they don't, the ball hooks too much in the first 15 or 20 feet of the lane.
And Scott keeps his hopes alive by converting that down by 22 pins. If he strikes in the 10th frame, all three in the 10th, he would finish with 205. Looks high again. And is. Just could not put it together. He's going to finish with 194 if he makes the two pin and strikes. Mr. Shady's going to move on to bowl Del Ballard for the championship if he can keep the ball in the lane.
So for the second time in about, 7-8 weeks, Shady's going to get a chance to win his first title. And he knows the man that stands between he and a trip to the Firestone Tournament of Champions is one of the best right now in the PBA Tour, Del Ballard Jr.
And Del Ballard's going to do it differently than everybody else. He's going to be starting that ball in around the fourth arrow and sending it out to the gutter and hooking it all over the lane.
One of the best in the world at doing that.
.33 and .34 must not have been too easy on the left side. Mm-hmm. Parker shoots in the 140s and Scott a clean 192 or 3 as the pin falls over. And neither one of them, not a double on the left side of the lane. Only two strikes.
Devers ground out about as much as he could get out of that performance and shot 193. For Mike Shady, it's just show-up time in the 10th frame.
I think he needs four pins to be a winner. And right down the middle, he didn't fool around with it. Says I can strike there, too.
I was just going to say, the reaction wasn't too bad. The ball held pocket, hit pretty hard, and Shady continues to sachet right into the finals.
See, that's the difference between the modern player and the contemporary modern player and the older player. They don't like that whole pocket and the ball goes straight. They want to see that big hook.
The sweeper, the Hoover.
Right.
That right-to-left action, or if you're a lefty, the left-to-right action. That's a little more like it right there. Rev it up and leave the solid five pin.
It rolled out a little bit too much there.
One of the tips, Mike, you're going to have to do is making the five pin.
You know that
because
actually
you
does
shot it perhaps more than any other professional player.
Does. But it does panic a lot of amateur bowlers. They have a mental block on that five pin.
Hey, you're going to leave them.
And at the Firestone Tournament of Champions, it was the key shot. Amleto Monticelli missed the five pin against David Ozio. It turned out to be the key shot of the game.
There you go. Nothing is a certainty in this game of bowling. 217 to 193. Shady advances. He has won three consecutive matches. Next up, the top seed, Del Ballard Jr. The winner will collect $23,000. Second place, $12,000. But for Shady, he's looking for his first ever PBA title.
We know how hard you work. We'll work that hard for you. We believe in putting people first in everything.
Taking better care of themselves and their money. That's why they're spending more time at McDonald's today. For food and prices that are right for the times, served up with the kind of service that made McDonald's McDonald's. It's all part of getting more for your money. That's McDonald's today.
Dear Thompson's, midway through waterproofing, I ran out of Thompson's water seal and finished with another brand. Then it rained. You could see the difference. Thompson's worked. The other side looked like I hadn't used a thing. Nothing tops Thompson's. Sincerely, Marcia Jackalone.
Beware of HBO's all-new episodes of Tales from the Crypt. You won't believe your eyes. You may lose your grip. Or get a little jumpy. That's how it goes with our terrific tales of murder, madness, and mayhem. And that's just the fun part. Tune in and you just might be another satisfied customer. Tales from the Crypt. It's only on HBO.
Pittsburgh's killer bees are putting the sting to the rest of the National League. Barry Bonds and Bobby Bonilla lead the first-place Pirates against the Giants. Live at 8 Eastern on ESPN Sunday Night Baseball.
Championship Frame is brought to you by Midas for mufflers, brakes, and shocks. Nobody beats Midas. Nobody. And let's pick up the trail here in the latter stages of game number one in the 10th frame.
And Mike Shady needed 9 on this last ball in order to emerge a victor over Billy Oaks. Got a little left to where he wanted to, and at this point wasn't sure, but he leaves the solid 4-pin just enough. He says, all right. He knows he needed 9.
Pretty excited about that last shot. As close as it gets, 216 to 215. So Oaks finished 5th. Shady went on to take on Parker Bone the 3rd in game number 2, and it was a big break in the 3rd frame early on.
Right, he was working on a double, and already Parker had an open. A strike here puts him in commanding position, and you can see how far left he had this. Watch the ball. Appears to be headed high and kind of straightens out at the end. The rollout shot, 4-7-10, go down, and that put him ahead early, and Parker just never could get anything going. When the O's beat the X's, as they did there, 4-2 or 4-3, you know you're in trouble.
Too many donuts on that scoreboard, 226 to 143. And then it was this crucial baby split conversion that was the difference.
In the 9th frame, he was up by 22. This cut it. If he makes it, it's 20. If he doesn't, it's less than 10. Perfect conversion. Kept the pressure on Devers, and he couldn't respond.
Shady has been the man here this afternoon. 217 to 193. Championship frame has been brought to you by Midas for mufflers, brakes, and shocks. Nobody beats Midas. Nobody. The question is, can somebody beat Mike Shady? Mike, I'm coming out of the shade. Shady and Del Ballard Jr. in the championship game here at Earl's Place in Dublin. Don't go away.
For 35 years, Midas has been providing quiet, installing quality products for clean, safe, and quiet driving.
Well, it's time we made some noise! Yeah! Midas announces Quiet Iron Day. We're celebrating our anniversary with great values on quality muffler, brake, and suspension services. Guaranteed. So get to the riot, and we'll provide the quiet. The Midas Quiet Riot. For great values, nobody beats Midas.
Nobody!
Always exciting, always something new. Always an adventure, always something to do.
If it happens in baseball, you'll see it on ESPN.
There he goes. He leaps. He makes the catch.
See Tuesday night doubleheaders, Wednesday night excitement, Friday night twin bills, and exclusive Sunday night action. Pittsburgh's killer bees are putting the sting to the rest of the National League. Barry Bonds and Bobby Bonilla lead the first-place Pirates against the Giants. Live at 8 Eastern on ESPN Sunday Night Baseball.
Mike Shady, the challenger in the top seed, Del Ballard Jr., looking for his 8th professional win and his 3rd here of the 91 season.
Starts it in around that 4th arrow, sends it out wide, but not wide enough. The 3-6-10 right out of the gate.
A little jumpy, perhaps. Looked like he raised up just slightly on that opening offering.
Well, you see his elbow. He knew he flew with the old flying elbow. We see here at 15 feet... He's in around the 18th and a half board, sends it out only at 55 feet to the 12th board. He actually wanted to get that ball wider. And we could see, though, looking at that, that he did get it down the lane wide, but he'll throw it straight at despair.
3-6-10.
You know, that's one of the differences I see between the modern bowler and the older-time bowler. Years and years ago, we used to throw the same shot at the strike and the spare, and then the modern contemporary player, almost all of them throw it straight at those spares.
Yeah, but the oil was longer, he had the lacquer condition, the ball didn't overreact like it does nowadays.
Well, that's true, too.
Got to do what you have to do to get that thing down the lane. Shady with a deep knee bend and a solid strike to open up the championship game.
And you wonder what's going through his mind at this time. You know, he's trying to take it one shot at a time, but just a few weeks ago, he bowled for his first title. Winning these three matches makes him tied for the lead with Bob Benoit. It's the most victories in the championship round. If he wins this one, he not only wins the title, but he takes that lead. He's 8-2 right now. Only lost two games, but one of them was for a title.
Wants to put the pressure on early, and he does as he jumps up and reacts.
And Billy Oakes, you know, you think back on it, how important one pin is. If he'd have won that first match, he might be bowling for this title right now because the two left-handers didn't bowl anything.
Yeah, instead of sitting in euchre seat, he'd have been in the hot seat on the championship round pair. How quickly it changes. Much better stretch-out shot for the top seed who strikes on the right hand lane, and Dell also wanted to wish his dad a happy Father's Day, and I know that Dad's probably a little nervous right now, but he's holding on.
Dad, if I win today, it'll be for you, and happy Father's Day, and I hope I keep it on the lane.
Referring to perhaps that miscue against Mr. Weber earlier this year. Uh-oh, that one flirted with the ditch and ends up leaving the bucket.
And I asked Dell, I said, how many ones did you throw in the channel this week? He said, oh, about 15.
No big deal?
No big deal, right. 2-4-5-8, the dinner bucket, not the easiest spare. It'll be interesting to see if he throws it straight at this or whether he tries to hook it at it.
I think that's what he's trying to determine right now.
Straight.
Beautiful shot by Dell Ballard Jr., who converts the dinner bucket.
Here's the first ball. This was the first ball where he left the bucket. We could see at 15 feet, it was 16 and a half. Only slowed down 0.4 miles.
That's the first frame
shot
on lane 33.
Okay.
Now let's take a look at the one where he leaves the bucket.
Uh-oh. Oh, okay. Well, this one, he got out three boards further down the lane. But the speed didn't slow down at all.
The Ballard boomerang shot. Meanwhile, back at the ranch, Shady continues to pepper the pocket, and he's done nothing but leave fours and tens for most of the day.
But he's kept the heat on his opponent all the way through because they know he's not making any mistakes. I don't think he's had an open so far in three games plus. But he was cruising along like this a few weeks ago, John Mazza. Hadn't had an open either. Suddenly he got a pocket 7-10, and it was lights out.
Yeah, got the wake-up call, huh?
Yep.
Right now, he's just trying to stay in that dreamlike trance. Whoop. Execute, throw it one shot at a time.
Walk back, wipe the ball off, wipe the shoe off, and get up there and throw another ball in the pocket.
Deep breaths, positive mental thoughts. Very talented young player.
But that first victory is just so hard to come by, especially against a quality player like Dell Ballard.
Oh, this one's far from over. Dell will make his run before it's all said and done.
Good speed. Good result. Quality shot right there. Making a lot of quality shots. And we see that he starts it at 17.7 miles per hour, only slowed down to 0.8 miles. Hooks 5.5 boards in the last 5 feet.
Dell turned it early. And is the recipient of a wonderful break for the Brooklyn strike on 34.
Crossover strike. What's going through his mind, though, now? I mean, he's gotten 7-6 on lane 33. The 3-6-10 the first time when he didn't get it wide enough, got it wider and left the dinner bucket. And he's asking for a re-rack. He hasn't hit the pocket yet.
Well, I think if it's me, now's the time when you make your most aggressive shot because you're on a strike and you got to go with what got you there. Thank you.
There's the old rollout shot, trips the four and the nine. Should mention at this point, then, when we see this bowler track and we see the different places that the ball is at 55 feet, like it said, 11 and a half right now. The pocket, solid in the pocket, is board 17. So you subtract 11 and a half from 17, and what do you get? 5 and a half. It hooked a lot in those last five boards.
Saving the best for last. A one-pin match. Oh, the pressure mounts, and that double does tighten up an arm swing.
And it's a deja vu thing to him. He hadn't had it open until about this point a few weeks ago, and suddenly now he was one pin behind. He's going to fall further behind if he doesn't convert this, which the chances are not too good. It's nine out. Suddenly he's bowling a 197 game and is down 13 pins, and his opponent is staring at a double. So the whole psychology of the thing changes with that one shot. Ballard gets the break with the Brooklyn strike and the trip out of the 410, or the 4-9. Shady makes the mistake.
And will he be able to come back and put that shot behind him? There's still five frames left.
Well, you talked about that positive self-talk. That's what he needs to do.
Good shot, a little bit right of target as he leaves the 10 pin.
But at least a very professional shot to get right back in the 1-3 pocket. He's got to hope right now that Ballard just slows down and doesn't keep striking.
I'm going to say he's hoping for a lot right there.
Yeah, Dell has been not real solid. I mean, he's missed the pocket three times in five frames.
No mistakes.
Ooh. Ooh. He breathes a little sigh of relief there.
Ahead by 13, could extend it to 23 and 33 if he comes up with two more strikes. You don't win all the big ones unless you can execute right in this position.
You hear him say, come on, boy. He knows how to win matches and when are key shots in a game. And that was definitely a key shot, and this one's even more important.
When you talk about winning matches, he won his last six games last night, averaged better than 240 in the final eight games. As a matter of fact, he won 12 of his last 13 match games.
He wants to make a 13 out of 14. Here's, he asked for his second re-rack now. He is out of re-racks. There's 10 pins at the end. He's got to shoot them no matter what configuration they're in. But they're all pretty much on spot.
Trying to load up, put together a four-bagger, and really put the heat on Shady. An aggressive shot. Ballard liked it, and rightfully so. The former Firestone champion has just really exploded here in the middle of this title match.
Former U.S. Open champion and ABC Masters champion, and that's how he did it because, again, you know, it's match game play and making those crucial shots in very pressure situations. A young player like Shady had the chance in the fifth frame and didn't come through. Oh, and his third solid eight. You know, he makes the mistake and pays the penalty there and then comes back and throws two balls in the pocket, and it's 9-9, and he falls further and further behind, and he's almost out of the match now. It turns around so quickly in our sport.
Boy, it did this time, didn't it?
If you don't keep striking.
4-6-7. The albatross for Mike Shady.
At the 8-pin, has it with no trouble, but right now, the best Mike Shady can get is 226 if he gets four strikes or five strikes in a row.
And don't forget, coming up a little later on ESPN, beginning at 7:30, Speed Week, and then IHRA Drag Racing starts at 8 o'clock, and then USAC Sprints and Midgets. If that's not enough racing for you on ESPN, well, one more time tomorrow, the Champion Spark Plug 500 live beginning at noon, 9 a.m. Pacific time.
Has to strike here, Dennis.
Needs it and doesn't get it. Shady, who led the match after five frames, saw the whole thing just tumble down.
Well, it'd be interesting to see if Ballard maintains the intensity or whether he thinks he's got it won and relaxes and lets him back into it here in the eighth frame. Well,
Wheels have come flying off for Mike Shady, who bowled just beautifully through 3.5 games. And then all of a sudden, that was it.
It's a carbon copy of the match against Mazin. I mean, it's just like...
Well, you know what he needs to do? He needs to qualify first, then. Or second. Oh, a near mistake by Del Ballard, who went through the nose and left the 3-6. So this one's not over yet, but the fat lady is beginning to hum a little bit, huh?
Just about. I mean, again, when Ballard has made his mistake, he's either struck or gotten a spare out of it.
204 for Shady would be the best possible score. Yeah, you're right. The Brooklyn in the fourth was the one that started to turn the momentum. And then you got to give credit to Dell because he came back and threw three great shots after that. Took advantage of the big break.
He took advantage of the break, but he got another break in the fifth frame when he tripped out the four and the nine. It could have something could have stood there. But the key shot in the game was, you know, the sixth and seventh frames when he just got up to his two best shots of the match to put this match away.
Trying to slow down just a touch and realize all he's got to do is take care of business to win his eighth title and third of the year. Oh, beautiful shot there. Just like a champion. Key shot in the ninth.
See, he knows that. Absolutely locked it up. He can get up in the 10th and open in the 10th frame and still win this match. So it's nothing that Mike Shady can do except try and finish out and finish with 204. But Del Ballard is going to be the winner of the 1991 Kessler Earl Anthony Dublin Open.
Mm-hmm. Boy, what a race for Player of the Year, huh?
Right.
Woo, this is really going to get interesting as the summer rolls on and into the fall. There are a handful of people, four right now, that have an even Steven shot at it.
Won three titles, you know. We've had a lot of tournaments. And
you know, that's so unusual on the PBA Tour. Usually it's one or two players pretty much dominate for the year, or nobody does. But, boy, four guys with three titles? I don't know that that's ever happened in a long time.
I can't remember it ever happening.
And we've still got 10 or more tournaments to go, right, for the touring pros?
And poor Mike Shady just can't buy a break.
Dell realizing that he's going to be in the winner's circle. Shady from 60th to 42nd to 14th. Then went from 10th to 5th last night. A long way to go.
And then from fifth to second here.
Three tremendous games, did what he had to do to win, was in a position to maybe make some travel arrangements for Akron, Ohio, the Firestone Tournament of Champions, but not to be, as he congratulates Del Ballard Jr., and for Mike Shady, it'll be a game in the 180s after all that work. Did he run out of gas?
No, he didn't run out of gas. At least I don't.
Did he take the gas?
I don't want to say that about anybody.
Just kidding.
But he definitely had the opportunity with the fifth frame where he split there and fell way behind.
Beautiful shot. And he says, I know how to strike. I can do it. I'll tell you what, you have to admire the attitude and the character of a youngster that was within striking distance of collecting that first title, which he so desperately wants.
It's easy in that situation to let bitter thoughts come in or angry thoughts or something. And he appears to be in a mental frame of mind that's saying, well, you know, I didn't do it, and I've got to have more positive self-talk here and do it the next time.
Right. Well, it's pretty evident that he has what it takes to get to the championship round on a consistent basis. Del Ballard having fun.
And this man has what it takes to win on the PBA Tour.
Back-to-back victories. He and Benoit won the doubles in the last PBA event. Who knows? He's heading up to the Great Northwest, maybe three in a row. A player of his caliber, he can do it. The winner, Del Ballard Jr., who now has nearly $100,000 in earnings in 91 and three titles, is the victor. 226 to 184. We'll be back to wrap things up from Dublin, California, right after these messages.
I burn with desire each time my heart fans the fire to that old flame that burns inside of me. There's nobody in his right mind would have left her. Even my heart was small.
The music of George Strait.
brought to you by Bud Light.
You don't have to worry when rain keeps pouring down, cause your home can take it whatever comes around.
Olympic Oil Stain has pure linseed oil. Since oil and water don't mix, it helps stop water damage.
It's no wonder we'll stop the rain.
Olympic stops the rain. All Olympic products are on sale now for a limited time at Sears.
Now appearing at a Burger King near you, a cool new star, Snickers ice cream bar, rich milk chocolate, buttery caramel, and fresh roasted peanuts, together with a cool taste of premium ice cream. Just the way you like it. So have it your way with the coolest new star, Snickers ice cream bar at Burger King.
All across the USA, as long as we've been around, our passengers are our neighbors. This country's our hometown. Every time we fly, every mile of sky, everything we do, USA, USA begins with you.
The championship round finals of the $140,000 Kessler Open have been brought to you by Desinex. If you don't know the score, don't blame Desinex. By Pizza Hut, home of the incredible picnic pairs deal. Pizza Hut, making it great. And by Olympic, the family of products that protect your home from damage rain can do. Olympic stops the rain. All right, the champion of the Kessler Open, Del Ballard Jr., a wonderful victory against a player who had won three straight matches. It wasn't going to be easy.
No, it wasn't. He bowled great the first three matches. I came out very scared. I was very scared the first four frames. I was tentative. I got the Brooklyn strike in a fourth, I guess it was, and it made me mad. And I said, I'm a better bowler than that. And that pumped me up for the rest of the match.
And speaking of better bowlers, PBA Hall of Famer and co-proprietor here, Ted Hoffman, has not only the check but also the trophy to present to Del Ballard.
Del, it's a double pleasure for me today to present you the trophy and a check for $23,000. On behalf of Kessler Whiskey and Earl Anthony and myself, congratulations. I know it's your third title this year, and I want to wish you luck for that Bowler of the Year honor. And I want to congratulate all the bowlers who made the TV show. Mike Shady, you're going to win soon, Mike, so keep it up. Thank you.
Yes, he will. I agree with that. He will. He will definitely win. I want to thank everybody here, Ted Hoffman especially. He was great to me all week. Got me a tea time at a local country club and felt great. And I'd like to thank Kessler Whiskey. They do a great job for us every year, and I'm very happy to, you know, that I won their tournament.
One final question. We've got about a minute left. You've won back-to-back now. You and Benoit win the doubles. You win here in Dublin. The Great Northwest is next in line. Could you win three in a row?
Oh, I don't know. I think my best finish in Seattle is like 50th. I barely cashed by two or three spots, so it's going to be real rough next week.
Michael, a question for our newest champion?
Well, you got three victories so far this year. Are you beginning to think about Bowler of the Year?
Not really. There's way too many tournaments left. John Mazza's bowled great all year. So is David Ozio. You know, they're two great bowlers, and I'm just getting to my third title now, and they've already had them for a while, and so I think this will be very tough for me, but I'm going to give it my best shot.
And I'm sure that'll be a good shot.
Yeah, hopefully on the lane, too.
Yeah, I was going to say, you step up in the 10th, and you didn't have to make the pressure shot. That had to feel pretty good.
Yeah, I was thinking about that. This lane hooked quite a bit to the right, so I knew that if I had to have one in the 10th, I'd want to be on this lane so I could get it on out there.
Well, we're going to say goodbye here from Earl Anthony's Dublin Bowl and congratulate Del Ballard, who's won a number of major titles, and you have a pretty good reason why, because of the way he performed here this afternoon. So long, everyone. Next week, the PBA Summer Tour on ESPN heads to Richfield Bowl in Flint, Michigan for the championship round finals of the Flint PBA Senior Open, beginning at 7:30 p.m. Eastern.